In this video, I'd like to talk through some of the custom fixturing we created for this fifth axis tombstone. I want to focus on how Mastercam helped us create the soft jaws for Op 2 and this custom fixture for Op 3. Let's jump into Mastercam and start with the soft jaws. The first step was getting the parts in the locations needed on the tombstone. That meant standing the part up in the opposite orientation of Op 1 and gripping by the finished part surfaces. Since these are finished surfaces, we can't mar that finish. A great application for the pre-made soft jaws that Fifth Axis sells for their self-centering vices. We needed the part protruding far enough from the jaws that the end mill can access the full depth of these tapered walls. The other issue we are facing with this setup is the Cam Instructor logo. The jaws will also need to be clearance for this. I could do this with a Boolean remove, but since I have two separate bodies making up the soft jaws, I would need multiple copies of the part and do two separate Boolean operations for each body. Instead, let's use model prep, specifically split solid face and push pull. I'll set the Z depth to the top of the jaw and set the drawing mode to 2D. Set the display to translucent, and using curve on one edge, I can draw the boundary of the part, omitting the fillets. I'm only going to do one pocket for now, as the other one will be the same process. Shut off the part solid, and since I don't want interference between the part and soft jaws, I'll offset the two longer lines by 2/1000ths, using the move mode in offset. Now I'll fillet the corners at the matching radius of the part, 1/8 inch. Because of the previous offset lines, these fillets should not create any interference. From here, I can split the solid faces of the jaws using these lines. Now push-pull that to the bottom of the part face, or 0.232 inches. Turning the Op 2 part back on, this looks like it should work well, but we will still need to clearance the part for the Cam Instructor logo. Using a typical extrude would work fine here, but I love the flexibility of model prep, and I'll use a similar process here. I'll offset a couple of lines that will allow enough clearance around the logo. Then I'll split the two solid faces. Once split, use push-pull to drag the model down to allow enough clearance to access the logo with the 1/4 inch Mitsubishi carbide drill we will be doing the engraving with. Finally, I can use push-pull again to add some radii to the cutout to make this feature manufacturable. With some creative use of Boolean, I could mirror this feature around to the other side, but this was easy and fast enough to use the same process. Now that we've talked through the process with the soft jaws, let's talk a little bit about the custom fixture that makes up the third operation on the tombstone. I'll navigate to the second view sheet. Here you can see that I've already extracted some wireframe from the part, using clearances so that the part only touches on the inner bottom edge, bottom internal face, and one end. When designing fixtures, you want to minimize the number of points of contact as to not create interferences, making the part difficult to load or compromise the repeatability of the setup. I do want to call some attention to this top corner. I can't leave this sharp as it would be impossible to machine, but if I fillet it, I'll create interference with the part. Instead, I'll use a little known Mastercam feature that I love for fixture design, a relief fillet. The relief fillet has been a feature in Mastercam for decades, but not something everybody thinks about inside the fillet command. I'll create a quarter inch relief and then blend that in with a standard eighth inch fillet. At this point, I'm ready to either extrude cut this feature or use model prep to create it. This will make for an easy to machine feature using one tool. I've found that usually the most successful custom fixtures are also the simplest. Time is money, and reducing time spent machining fixturing is critical. Let's go over to the machine and check it out. To load, open the clamps, slide the part in, and then over. Holding the part in place, engage the pinch clamps. We ordered these clamps from an online vendor, downloaded some 3D models, and using Merge, I brought those into Mastercam and positioned them. On this project, utilizing off-the-shelf modular fifth axis work holding and a little ingenuity, we were able to get these parts coming off the machine in a fraction of the time. Hopefully you picked up a few things here, and as we progress in this video series, we are going to touch on planes, tooling, stock models, and even toolpath programming.